Hello, my name is Rainer Hanekamp. This is EngineWiz with the latest updates from the Angular community every week. Domain-driven design, or DDD, helps us slicing a large system into smaller several parts. That could be modules with a very high degree of isolation, so something which we want to have for a scalable architecture. Manfred Steyer from Angular Architects has been covering DDD for quite some time, and he has now released a huge article about that topic. He first starts with the why and then discusses the terminology we use. For example, bounded context, ubiquitous language, context mapping, etc. DDD is quite common in the backend, and very often we can reuse the same boundaries, the same models. Nevertheless, a common question is if the frontend requires its own boundaries, its own models. And to answer that, Manfred writes about event storming, which is a technique that not only helps to identify domains and bounded context, but also indicates if separate models for the frontend are needed. So the frontend as a bounded context is a reality which especially quite complicated applications have to face. Manfred doesn't stop at the theoretical level. He also discusses how the implementation could look like. If a bounded context can be an own application, an own library, or just a folder. The Angular Animations library has been part of the framework for several years. Over time, though, a lot of things have changed. Things where we required that library are now available natively. And that's a problem, because Angular Animations runs in JavaScript, whereas native animations can make use of the browser's possibility to access hardware acceleration. And it's really hard to integrate third-party libraries. Still, the Angular team wants to provide a single and ergonomic way to define animations when DOM elements enter or leave the page. The short story, Angular animations will be deprecated. In its place, Angular introduces lightweight animate-in and animate-out bindings. Similar to the new control flow syntax, these will be part of the framework itself. No need for additional imports. The RFC is now open and you are invited to share your feedback. And if you want to play around a little bit, there is also a StackBlitz version available. Alex Rickapo, the Angular framework lead, gave a 15-minute lecture at TechStack Nation about the problem with Reflow in the context of afterNextRender. Reflow is the process where the browser is recalculating the layout of DOM elements, for example, their size or their position. It usually happens when the DOM changes or when the styles are going to change. Reflow is usually efficiently scheduled by the browser. However, we can run into performance issues when JavaScript code reads layout-specific properties like offset height or get bounded client react. These reads are synchronous and force the browser to perform a reflow immediately, possibly too early. Another potential issue is when we want to both read but also write to the DOM independently from each other. In that case, the write should happen before and the read should happen after the reflow has been run as scheduled by the browser. Now, afterNextRender and afterRenderEffect provides us with options where we can define in which phases our code should be executed. And that's it. I wish you a nice week. See you in the next episode. Goodbye.